Celebrity chef Carlos Brown is here for a wonderful homecoming tasting dinner event August 23rd. I'm going to let him tell you all about it. Welcome back to Charleston.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Boy, that man can cook. Y'all, that man can cook. He can cook.
A little something, a little something.
Tell us all that you've been doing.
Oh, God. The list goes on and on. So now, one of my proud moments, of course, I'm in the museum in the Smithsonian African American Museum.
I see it. I saw it.
In Washington, D.C. Mm-hmm. So that's an honor to be from Charleston to be in that museum. Okay. So that's good. I've had the opportunity to work with Oprah Winfrey. Mm-hmm. Next week, I'll be with Michelle Obama.
Wow.
Yes. And Oprah again, and Viola Davis, all those great people, Tyler Perry. So I had the opportunity to represent the Lowcountry, give mm-hmm. me some of our food, the shrimp and grits.
I went to Selma, Alabama to go to that hotel where you were the chef.
Wow. St. James.
Yes, I did go there and walked across the Edmund Pettus Bridge.
There you go. There you go. Great, great, great place. I actually stayed in that hotel.
Okay.
Many nights.
Okay.
And that's where Oprah was.
So now you're coming to Charleston to host a dinner.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
I want to do something special for Charleston. Come home. I want to do a tasting. People look at me all the time and say, you go everywhere around the world. When are you coming home?
Okay.
So I decided, let me bring it home.
Bring it home.
Let me bring it home. Because this is where it is. This is where it started for me.
Yes, because a friend of mine went to a restaurant one time in North Carolina and saw the name Watermelon John's Island. And said, someone here has to be from the Lowcountry.
Absolutely.
And it was you.
It was me. It was me. I always represent where I'm from. Because I think all these unique things that they have here in the South Carolina and Lowcountry need to be shared to the world. So mm-hmm. that's what I do. I take it out there.
So how did you get started in all of this?
Of course, I started in the church.
Cooking those Sunday afternoon dinners.
Sundays. I mean, but really, I started with a kid at Morris Brown.
Okay.
You know, cooking these little meals for the adults, and they started thinking me. A matter of fact, Reverend Blake says, "Man, you could cook.
Okay.
You ought to be a chef." I didn't believe him at the time, but hey, here am I today. That's my roots.
And you're cooking for all these famous people.
Yes, yes. It's been great. It's been a great experience. A lot of football players, NFL, I do a lot of those guys meal planning. You know, I just use what we do here, fresh herbs, fresh garden, and all those things I bring back to these people and say, hey, this is what you guys are missing. This is where it is in Charleston. If mm-hmm. you haven't had Charleston, you haven't ate food.
Mm-hmm. So then, I guess you're telling our public, if you have a gift and a desire to do something, work at it.
Work at it. And stay with it. You know, I discovered my gift. I work at it. I continue to push it out there. People get excited about it. But I know it's inside of me. So I felt like, you know, there was something great in me that needed to be out there more than just going to the stove. So I practiced my gift. You know, I developed the gift and I continue to make it grow every day.
Every day.
Keep learning.
Keep learning.
Keep learning.
I've seen pictures with you with Oprah Winfrey, Whoopi Goldberg.
Yes, Whoopi. Yep. Those are all great experiences. And they get a chance to taste our food because they were like, everybody excited about Charleston. So when I went there, they were like, wow, this guy is really from Charleston. You know, I remember Susan Taylor from The Essence. Susan loved me. She was in New York City, and she found out I was in New York. Susan sent for me.
Okay.
Come get my food. And no matter what, whatever he makes, that's what I want to eat.
So on August 23rd, what can we expect?
Oh, you're going to expect some great stuff. I'm going to do some authentic shrimp and grits. Because some people play with the shrimp and grits. I'm bringing it back where it really is.
Where it really started.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to bring the shrimp and grits back home. You can't play with shrimp and grits.
Okay.
You know, so we got some special things. We got some wonton collard greens. Mm. You know, so we got some dishes that's from here that we kind of just did a fusion. And with this fusion we did, we make all this food come together and just become exciting. Food is art. You know, and that's what I like about it. It's art, and I have fun. I don't call myself a chef anymore. I call myself an artist.
Come on now.
It is artistry.
So the purpose of this event is to do what?
Just really to celebrate home, number one, and also the city is honoring me as well. There's a proclamation going forth from the city of Charleston. I raised up in downtown Charleston,
yes, sir,
which is fantastic to be able to come from the projects.
Yes, sir.
And to be able to be successful coming out of that place. So I also want to encourage people that, you know what, I've done it, you can do it as well.
Okay, so this event will happen August 23rd, 6:30 p.m. at the Marion's in the French Quarter, 159 East Bay Street in Charleston. And you said it's cocktail attire.
Yeah, I got to come sharp now.
Sharon Carson, put your best on.
Yeah. Got to come sharp.
And the tickets are what? $65 or $75.
$75. Eventbrite.
You go to eventbrite.com.
Absolutely.
Then go to chefcarlosbrown.com.
There you go.
To get the information. Well, I'm so happy to see you back in Charleston.
Thank you so much.
And on August 23rd, I plan to be there.
It's going to be good.
Are you going to make some she crab soup?
You know what? Since you called for it, you got it.
Oh.
You got it. You called for it, you got it.
I got it?
You got that.
Okay.